Hey guys, today marks the start of our Energy Amplifier Fruition event. So in this event, firstly, we want to start off with going to Hoseini. So we will need to talk to this guy, which is located over here. And once done, we will start to unlock this event. So this event requires us to do a bunch of prerequisite tasks, which involves us destroying a bunch of monsters to collect a chest. So the caveat here is that we might have to destroy these stones, which will buff the enemies. However, if you are stacked enough, you can actually just clear this with brute force alone, and you don't have to rely on any of the destroying of the stone. So as you can see, I've brought a team with me that doesn't really do much against this stone, so I actually don't have the potential to destroy the stone, so the enemies will maintain the buff throughout the entire duration. However, it's still possible to brute force through this entire thing, which I show in this this little showcase over here. Once done with this first one, we'll then proceed on to the next one, which is actually just around the corner over here, as you can see, and we'll do the same thing. So again, I didn't bring anyone to destroy the stones, so we will not be destroying the stones and just relying on brute force. Alright, so once done, once again, don't forget to claim the chest afterwards. And then we will proceed on to the last one. So for this last one, I actually show you guys how to work around the stones. So we'll bring a claymore unit, but you can also achieve the same results with plunging attacks, overload reactions, and geo attacks, because this is basically a stone, right? So in this showcase, I'll only be using a claymore unit, which is probably the easiest and most accessible way to destroy the stones. So my Chongyun here is going to put in some work. Alright, so after we destroyed the stones, I cut out that part where I destroyed the other stones. But basically, after we destroyed the stones, we realized that our damage is actually much higher against the monsters. And without much buffs or anything, I just destroyed this Mitachou, as you can see in this clip. Alright, once done, don't forget to claim the chest once again. But now it's a little bit different, because when we go back to the Hoseini, right? He will have the next part of the quest available for us, which is basically the one where we can start to do the challenge, and that's probably the reason why you guys are watching this video anyway. So once we are ready, we can take a look at the single player setup if you are playing single player, and the co-op setup if you are playing co-op. Alright, so based on our max level of our characters, we will have a certain amount of motive force, which basically limit the amount of buffs we can carry in each of the challenges. Over here, you can take a look at some of the buffs. The purple ones are the strongest and the green ones are the weakest. Once we have selected all our buffs and are ready to go, we'll check in with Hoseini one last time before we proceed on. The next step for us is to go to this domain where we will select our debuffs. Alright, so first step, as per usual, is always to look at the monster lineup before we even select our debuffs. So I can already tell that there will be monsters from a lot of different elements in this challenge, so therefore I'll be using a very universal team, such as the Raiden national team. The next step for us is then to select the challenge criteria. So these challenge criteria are a bunch of debuffs, as mentioned earlier, where they will either buff the enemy or cause some sort of challenge that you have to work around in your team. However, sometimes it's not necessary to pick some of these debuffs. For instance, switching character during the challenge increases the damage taken by all characters in the player's party, and the one right below that, using an elemental burst. These two are very very game breaking for my team of Raiden National, because I'll be using a lot of elemental bursts and I'll be swapping in and out very frequently. From a casual standpoint, I would recommend that day 1, we just go with about 5k points, so there's no reason for us to go above that 5000, because the total amount of points needed to claim the max rewards is actually only 12,000, split among 3 challenges in these few days. Alright, so because I didn't go super insane on all of those buffs, or rather debuffs, you can see that I'm very comfortable when I'm fighting this domain, and this should be the case for you guys as well. So there's no point in over selecting all those debuffs, which will cause a lot of stress on you, which is unnecessary, because you can actually just claim the rewards with a score of 4000 or even 5000. If this challenge still proves difficult for you, you can actually do this in co-op with other players, as they might have better characters than you, or you might have even more synergy with. You can also use a food buff such as defensive food buff to avoid getting one hit by some of the more powerful attacks, or you can use offensive buffs to clear it in the stipulated time. After much testing, I realized that one of the most effective teams for this is Raiden National Team or any other national team convariance involving Burnett, Xiangling, and Xing Qiu as the core. Alright, so we cleared it with plenty of time to spare using no food buffs. Alright, so if you guys want to follow the route that I took, this is my debuffs and challenges that I took with me for this particular clear. Feel free to pause the video to copy it, and do leave a like and subscribe if this video has helped you thus far. Alright, so for the last part of this video, just for the science, I experimented to see what's the max score I can get with this current team setup using Raiden National, and eventually I got a total score of 7375 with no food buffs involved. This just goes to show how strong the team synergy in Raiden National is and other national team convariants. So in the last part of this video, you'll actually see my character builds, and you'll notice that I do not have the best artifacts, definitely, for most of my characters. Alright, so if you guys are still struggling with all these tips, you guys can actually go ahead and join the Discord server that I'm in, which is the Genshin Adventure Guild Discord server, mainly for Singaporeans and other Asian players. We do offer carrying services throughout this event period, where some of us veterans and other enthusiastic players with stacked accounts are more than willing to help you to clear your event so that all of us can enjoy the maximum rewards at 12,000 points total throughout this event period. If you do join, remember to say hi to me. Alright, with that, I think I can end off this video. So I hope that this guide has helped you guys. And do leave a like, comment, and subscribe if this video has helped you. Also, do consider to share this video with others who might be struggling with this event as well. And do consider to join our Discord server. My builds are at the end of this video if you guys want to see. But other than that, please enjoy the rest of this video.
やっ、あ、さあでしょ。見切りました。はい。この剣は分かるかい。さあ、ゆる。はあ、それ。くらい。全力攻撃。無我の境地。はっ。ストップ。ストップ。や、裁きのいかず。燃えろ。
いたように。そこ。一体どこから。
Like, comment, subscribe.